children, today I am going to continue yesterday's lesson, that is human about the development lesson. In that I am taking the subtopic as human development indicators. The average of three indicators, so the total average of three indicators, what are those three indicators? Life expectancy of the people, educational achievement and per capita income is called human development index. So I'll repeat once again, the average of three indicators such as life expectancy of the people, educational achievement and per capita income is called human development index. Human development index is calculated with the help of life expectancy, literacy attainment and per capita income. I'll repeat once again. Human development index is calculated with the help of life expectancy, literacy attainment and per capita income. Now, what are the causes of human development index of India? So first and foremost, the causes for the human development index is lack of food, lack of shelter, lack of clothing, lack of education, lack of health, lack of social security, lack of clean water, impure air, polluted environment. I'll repeat the causes of low human development index. They are, once again I'll repeat, lack of food, lack of shelter, lack of clothing, lack of education, lack of health, lack of social security, lack of clean water, impure air and polluted environment. So these are the causes for human development index. Now here, there are different economists who have told about this. The first and foremost is Mahbub al-Haq, a Pakistani economist. He inspired by the writings and Nobel laureate who Amartya Sen. So he was inspired, this economist was inspired by Amartya Sen. He was a Nobel laureate. He argued that the most important requirement to enjoy a decent standard of living is, first one is ability to lead a healthy and a long life, being literate, having income to purchase the minimum amenities called as human development. So I'll repeat once again, what are the three important requirements to enjoy a decent standard of living? First one is ability to lead a healthy and long life. Second is you must be a literate person, educated person. Third is having income. You must have income to purchase the minimum requirements or the minimum amenities, what you call as human development. So all these three considers for the important requirement to enjoy a decent standard of living. The next one, it is said by Amartya Sen, is that Amartya Sen defines the human development and expansion of capabilities of people. The core capabilities are, what are the three core capabilities of the people are? Health, education and purchasing power. So the three core capabilities of the Amartya Sen's expansion of the human development is, the core capabilities are health, education and purchasing power. Now, how to measure human development? First and foremost, the United National Development Program, that is UNDP, the United National Development Program has told that these ideas of construct and index is known as human development index. The United Nations Development Program has said that the ideas that constructs the index, about the mean index, is known as human development index. Health is, how the health is measured? Health is measured in the time of life expectancy. Education is measured in the terms of literacy attainment and purchasing power through per capita income. So health, education and purchasing power. Health, education expectancy, how much you are going to live, life expectancy. Education is measured in terms of literacy attainment, whether you are educated or not. And the third one, purchasing power, is through the per capita income. So this is about how to measure human development. Okay, the next is about the age. Means the life expectancy means, I told you the first one is about the health, education and purchasing power. First one, the age, life expectancy, the age till which the people of a country can expect to survive is called as life expectancy. Means the age the person is born in a country till he survives, till he lives in this earth is called as life expectancy. I'll repeat once again. The age till which the people of a country can expect to survive is called life expectancy. Availability of nutritious food, excellent health and hygienic facilities, clean environment, etc. enables us to live longer. So the availability of nutritious food, the good food, excellent health, the good health, and hygienic facilities, clean and hygienic facilities, clean environment enables us to live longer. So our life expectancy can increase if you get nutritious food, excellent health, very good health, good hygienic facilities, clean environment, etc. The education, next, the educational achievement of a country is measured in two factors. What are the two factors the educational achievement of a country is measured? The first and foremost is the average period of schooling completed by individual about 25 years. So the average period of schooling from where schooling means from the beginning till the age of 25 years is the first level, and the second level is the expected period of school education that the children of 5 years might receive in their lifetime. Okay, the second one is expected period of school education that the children of 5 years might receive in their lifetime is called as the two achievement of the country for the education. I'll repeat once again. First one is the average period of schooling completed by individual about 25 years. Second one is, and the expected period of school education that the children of 5 years might receive in their lifetime. So next, in 2014, HDI, that is the Human Development Index, was calculated at how much? 0.586. Was calculated, the Human Development Index in 2014 was calculated as 0.586 and ranked at 135 out of 187 countries. 135 out of 187 countries. So I'll repeat once again. In 2014, the Human Development Index was calculated as 0.586 and ranked at, out of 187 countries, our country was ranked as 135th country. Now next, the UNDP, what is the full form of UNDP children? United Nations Development Programme. Keep it in mind, the United Nations Development Programme classifies the countries into three categories based on Human Development Index. I'll repeat once again, the United Nations Development Programme of the country is classified into three categories. What are those? The based on which Human Development Index? India is in the middle group of human development. So India is in the middle. So UNDP classifies the countries into three categories based on Human Development Index. So India is in the middle. Okay, means you are. I earlier also in last class also I told you about the countries which are developed, which are developing and yet to be developed. So developing and underdeveloped countries are coming in one phase, and the developed countries are the progressing countries. So India is the middle group of human development. So this is the end of the human development indicator or human development index. Next topic I'll take is gender related development. Okay, now the next topic is gender related development. The role of women in the development process is very significant. When the women plays a major role in today's society, so without women a world cannot go forward, because women are assigned in many ways in many fields. So it is the duty of the civilized society to provide social, economic, educational and political equality to women. So the women should be treated equally in all the fields, that is social field, economic field, education field and political equality should be given to women. Our constitution after independence has assured an equality of freedom, means opportunity should be given both for women and men equally. So it was framed in our constitution that women should be given equal right. Women have got the right to speech, right to freedom. So women and men should be treated equally, was told by our, was framed by our constitution. Still, the sex discrimination and violence against women is existing. There is still in some places, some countries, you can see the violence, and the men dominate the women and they show the discrimination between the men and the women. Sex ratio, the number of females for every 1,000 males, means sex ratio means you are compared. For every 1,000 males, there should be 1,000 women. So sex ratio means the number of females for every 1,000 males is more important indicator which reveals the treatment method to the women in a society. So if the sex ratio for every 1,000 male, if there is 1,000 women, then the sex ratio is equally treated, means the women are equally treated according to men. If there is less, if the ratio is the males are 1,000 and the women are decreasing, that means the women are tortured, they are violent, or they are aborted before the birth, before the child is aborted in the womb of the mother. So all these are the results and consequences. So first and foremost, the women should be literate. Literacy rate among women was 65.46% in 2011. 65.46% in 2011. The literacy rate of women. 65.46 in 2011. The women rate literacy will and next in among compared to men, when you compare now, men were 82.14. The literacy rate of women and men. So of women it was 65.46, of men it is 82.14. That means the men are more educated than the women. People think women do not need education, and in some places adequate schooling facilities may not be available. In some places the schools are not available, and some places they think women's education is not so important. So women mainly work in an unorganized sectors or in unorganized activities. What are the unorganized activities? Like agriculture, construction, small scale industries. So these are all the unorganized sector where they are given the lower wages than the men. Unorganized sectors are those sectors, children, where there is no any rules, no regulations. It doesn't come under government control. There is no any fixed wages, they won't get any plus points, means the wages, everything, and their job security is not there. So all these are there, unorganized. So most of the women we see, they are working in agriculture, construction, small scale industries, etc. So the wages are lower than the men. It is true that women are free to, women in some places, they are not even free to spend the income what they are earning. Whatever they earn, they have to go and give it to their, in their homes. Means they are not free even to spend their own money what they have earned. So this is the way this makes her, even women, what do they do? Even in the houses you see, your mothers you see, they do the whole work, the whole day they work, they struggle. And what do they do at the end of the day? They'll be exhausted and tired. Even by sitting for dinner or food, after whole family members eat, then the women sit and eat. So this also will affect her health and malnutrition, especially even pregnant women, even the mothers who are toiling from morning till evening. Some of the ladies, they work outside and again they come home and toil in the house, and while eating food or while having anything, they are not considered, the women are not considered equally. And what they are doing because of this, the malnutrition, they are used to malnutrition, and malnutrition will cause to illness because of the heavy work, and even they fall sick. Even if they fall sick, some of the men, they don't bother to take them and give them the proper treatment and take care of their health. So India has more rates of mothers even dying during the delivery. When they are giving birth, even you can see the mothers dying because of malnutrition without proper food. And it is said that the infant and children below 5 years, our death rates are more. Why? Because of the mothers. Because mothers are not given proper food, they don't eat in proper way, they don't take care of their health, they won't treat themselves, they won't be having rest, they'll be toiling from morning till night. Evil practices detecting the gender features is even practiced today. Yes, if there is a female child in the womb of a mother, they detect through and they try to kill the child in the womb of the mother, they destroy the womb of the mother if they find the sex ratio is a female child. Representation of women in political bodies is limited and reserved strength. So now even in political party, only certain person is given to the women, whereas the women play a major role in all the fields. Thank you children for watching this.